Archie removed from Meghan Markle and Harry, Elizabeth II can claim custody. A real earthquake. By announcing their withdrawal from the royal family without consulting Queen Elizabeth II, this Wednesday, January the 8th, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry caused a real outcry. Even within Windsor, it is stupor. This new release will not be without consequences for the couple from Sussex. Her Majesty could even legally take over the custody of their son Archie if she wished. Even more toxic than Prince Andrew. This is what the critics claim. Meghan Markle and Harry may have just done the irreparable by announcing that they were distancing themselves from the royal family. Stupor and fury at the top of the firm, so nobody expected this coup. Talks were set to have taken place over the phone during the holiday season, but nothing happened. The Sussex would have a new act without consultation, as in October, with the broadcast of the disastrous documentary Harry and Meghan, An African Journey, prelude to their six-week break in Canada this January the 9th, almost repentant. Meghan and Harry made the effort to celebrate the birthday of Kate Middleton, even if they were absent from the little rehearsal organized in honor of the wife of William in Kensington. A lot of questions remain unanswered. Can they really claim to be financially independent? Will they really move to the other side of the Atlantic, as they have expressed the wish for the well-being of their couple and the development of their son Archie? On this last point, Elizabeth II could well thwart their plans. If the firstborn of the Sussex didn't receive a royal title at his birth last May at the request of his parents, it nevertheless remains the property of the Queen. According to a law dating from 1717, the British sovereign was legally assured of the custody of all minor children of the Crown. 10 judges out of 12 voted for this text over 300 years ago. At the origin of the decree, King George I, jealous of his son, the future King George II, and eager to assert his authority over his grandchildren. This isn't particularly the reason why William and Harry, or their cousins Eugene and Beatrice, more recently had to ask Elizabeth II for permission to marry. If, unlike his ancestor George I, His Majesty never interfered in the education of his grandchildren or his great-grandchildren. However, he upheld his supreme authority in the 90s. Thus, after her divorce from Charles, Diana never went on a trip with William and Harry without her permission. The law of 1717 also explains why the two brothers were never brought up by the brother and sisters of the late Princess of Wales, as she had meant in a will. Something to make Harry and Meghan think.